We painted this room down here, and he was he provided the brushes and the paint and all that, and the expertise in how we should do that, and we were just the workers, but he was the one that, he was the driver on it. So I'm going to turn it over to you now.
Great. All right, so I was supposed to present next week, but this is good to do this week. I won't have a chance to be nervous. And so even for next week, I was curious, you know, painting is kind of boring, really. You know, I was thinking of bringing a card and putting paint on it and watch it dry. I can put more on and show how it changed color. Until it's dry. Yeah, I thought about that. And when I asked the other day, you mentioned, Paula, people are curious what shine. Why do you pick what shine? There's like five things you need to know when you go to the paint store. You need to know how much to buy, and how much to want, what the shine is, what the brand is, and the color. And there's one other song. Tape, you know, things you need to go with it. But anyway, on the shine, on this room, we picked shine, a little bit of shine called eggshell. Eggshell's not necessarily color, it can be, but it's the shine. It's like it goes flat, eggshell, satin, semi-gloss, and gloss, in that order of shine. So you kind of, some people really don't like shine, and everything has to be flat. But every time you touch a flat wall, it leaves your fingerprint or mark. So they don't last as long. So you'll get a little bit of shine, which is an eggshell, that's what we did in here. Looking at it straight on, it looks flat, but in an angle, it's got a little shine. And in bathrooms and kitchens, where you have moisture problems and stuff, you need a barrier, so you put semi-gloss for that. So that's kind of how shines work. On trim and stuff, you usually put a semi-gloss also, because your hands touch them and stuff like that. So that was the shine stuff. And everybody, you know, tries painting here and there. Sometimes they do it all themselves. I have clients that have painted for years, and they say, oh, we're getting old, and we want you to do it. And I'm all nervous. They're critical and stuff. It turns out they're really quite happy to have me do it. And they're usually, I usually think of them all nervous, and they're all happy. So I'll ask them, I go, is this going to work? How's it going? That we're not having to do this. So I thought maybe if this time we could open up to questions that you have about your painting projects. Maybe you can do a deck this summer. That's a whole other animal. There's lots of things to that. Or maybe you just have some failing trim on the outside of your house. You're wondering, do I need to paint the whole house, or can I just touch this up? And we'll see if anyone has questions about their painting projects.
My question is, when it comes to color, I've heard that, at least from a staging perspective, I have probably five colors that I recommend people to go with. They're usually really subdued kind of whitish colors. And so when you see color on the wall, let's say someone has chosen a blue or a red or something like that, do you usually feel as if that was a good choice? I mean, I'm sure it depends on the room and that kind of thing, but in general, what is the best feel, would you say?
Yeah, some colors really have a good feel to it, and it's usually not the color on its own, it's usually, and Jess will know this, it's what it's going with and how it works with the whole feel of the room. As a general rule, you don't mix yellows with black, because one's cold, one's warm, and that kind of sets the tone for the whole project, to kind of keep in a range of warm or cold. So when you, like, if we painted this, well, here's a good example right here. White, it doesn't really go as yellow. And if these walls were all this white, it wouldn't go so well as this floor, because it has no color. They tend to fight each other, and you can look at it and just feel a little uncomfortable. And not really know why. Yeah, I don't like that color. You're like, colors, almost any color can work, and colors can be fun as long as they're working. So a lot of women, I try not to get excited about colors. So a little pick a color, but that's great for you. You want a purple door, purple's your favorite color, pink door your favorite color. So you come home, yeah. And it sets the tone. And it can be an accent, it doesn't have to go with it. It can be wild and crazy.
Yeah. But that does not work when you're selling house.
No, someone comes up to that door and says, no, don't like this house. It's purple. And they can't imagine pink to green, their favorite color. They just can't get there. That's a job. I can't do that. I'm on the clock here, and it's going to be
Yeah, I'm always concerned about smell. Kay is so sensitive to paint smells and formaldehyde and all these products. So, what is the best brand to get for this?
So, it'll say right on the can. Now, they list the VOC, volatile organic compound. And those are the compounds that cause nerve damage. Make you sick. Yeah, and they're bad for you, basically. So you can get no DLC, no odor, and it really is pretty not so bad. Or you might have a little ammonia smell or something. I don't know what's really in. It smells a little, but it goes away within 30 minutes when it dries.
Unless it's ever, can you recommend a brand?
Rares, use Rare. Yeah, and their higher end stuff has less than 50. VOC, which is kind of low, like oil-based steam, that might be up to 500 to 700, which is high. Oil-based paints are 400. So less than 50 is good, but you can get zero. And you just get the premium plus. So it says zero VOC.
Two questions. On the south side of the house, is there anything you can do? Our house is on the south side. Mm-hmm. And it seems we have to repaint it every year or two. And the other question is, once it starts peeling, other than scraping the primer, is there anything else you can do?
Yeah. The first part, Bear came up with this thing called Marquee that has fade resistance to it. It works pretty well. I did it actually in Barbie's house, country, the ugliest house in the world. The shed.
Oh, yes.
The big shed.
It's a lot better.
Yeah, and it lasts okay, but that was really dark and it faded also. When I had to go back 2 years and paint just the upper part, who was going to put himself and get around to it. Anyway, it faded too, but the best thing you can do is pick a lighter color that doesn't have as much to fade. And it's.
How do you keep it from peeling?
Okay, so you might have a problem that started from some application before you got the house, and you're kind of stuck with that because it's the siding wasn't done correctly years ago, and it'll just keep peeling over time from that problem. You can take those peeling spots, and there's a product called Peel Stop or Peel Block and sort of stuff. It's kind of like a thin Compton can. It's milky, thick. You use that can? Yeah, it works pretty good. Clients like it. I'm using some of that right now on some sites that you can't scrape real well. Yeah, Peel Stop or Peel Bond, depending on which manufacturer. It's the same thing. It's milky. You put it over the peeling areas, and it locks down the edges. And then you do it. It works pretty good.
Paul's absolutely correct on that. Surface. There was this product years ago called T111 siding, and it would hold paint.
No,
it's because they put so many preservatives in wood to make it last for a long time that it wouldn't connect with paint.
So, it's kind of like a rough plywood with grooves in it.
Yeah, it's just nasty.
Yeah,
it's terrible.
Peel.
It looks okay for the first couple of years, and of course the contractor for using it was cheap.
Oh, is that why?
Yes. Yeah.
If
you have it, if the siding is just, depends on how it's manufactured, it's got a lot of preservatives in it. But if they put a preservative in it, keep it from rotting.
Including stuff.
Yeah, the color, the resins and stuff.
So when you're looking to refinish a surface, for wood example, I've always heard that you want to sand it down and prepare it before you resurface it, but now there's all of these paints that are clean and you don't have to do that. What do you feel about those claims?
I feel that you know, using the peel on and stuff, scraping until it's not coming off of you, it's good, but you need to have a sound on the wall. That's why that was not feeling very good. It's that sound, it's crumbling, falling apart, and we didn't know whether we could scrape it or not, even though it's asbestos. So we just left it cold. That's why that's not good. Well, you need to have a sound, and I don't think the things are miracle primer and one paint stuff. They work pretty well. They stick to your hands like crazy. That's a good sign. Jesus shit. I still need to get that stuff. Now on sanding, if you look at that board and you think about how long you're gonna spend sanding that board, and you're still gonna have an old board, you might be able to take it off and put a new board on. I think that's especially if it has some kind of relief to it, if it's not smooth, you're going to lose the relief when you sand it, and you're still going to have it on the board. But, you know, you can buy a new board, put it on the lot easier when you can't sand it. And your health-wise, the dust from the sand is very bad.
What's quality in paint? So, you know, your bear, whatever it is, what do you really know about quality? How important is it to have you choose it?
If you're a chemist or something, you might know that this thing in paint, it means something. It used to be lead. Lead made paint color. That's why it was lead. Then it turned to titanium, different types of titanium. And now they come up with things that you could never imagine of. You can put oil in water-based paint. So emulsifying and combine somehow. And they can be good. And I used to use this polymer paint. I used to do pierce and kind of put everything and then they reformulate. That's the fun part. They're not something new like that. And then they come up with stuff. And I like the bear because their technology is above like the Tremors. The literature of millions is kind of catching up to the stuff that they put in their products.
So
Bear,
you said that's better than
Benjamin
Moore?
Mm-hmm. They just have newer technology. You know, I was resistant to technology with that Calamore stuff. It's like, but then I figured out they're making newer animals. And sometimes, if you have to pay $5, $10 more a gallon, it's worth your time. You're going to spend 4 hours doing it. I know it's a lot. Paint is so expensive. It's like $45. Better paint.
It's going to last longer, right?
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they work with them. And I can use it. I can give it to you. It's my home phone number. When you check out at Home Depot, it's called Pro Rewards. You push that button and it's your code. It's my home phone number. You can save 15%.
Well, thank you, Paul.
You're welcome.
If you've got any more questions, then you get with Paul. But thank you.